very, very important, and you know, the press are picking up on it, so it's helping us grow.
That's excellent, and it's really useful for us because, you know, we're trying to encourage more and more companies to come to Colombia. Sense that, you know, back there in the UK, people aren't sufficiently aware of the opportunities, so it's actually quite useful. And, you know, we'll talk about it, you'd be willing to act as a kind of case study for others to come.
What we produce and what we manufacture around the world is the oil, the raw material, which is a fragrance which goes into any product used in the personal care sector, the household sector, or the fragrance, the fine fragrance sector. So we produce the raw material. So that one product of ours is typically maybe 50 or 100 individual raw materials which go into that formulation. So our IP, if you like, is the formulation. That's what, and the perfumers, they're the geniuses, they're the people that create the essence, create the smell. And then we have development sites and commercial offices in Paris, in Bielefeld, in Germany, and in Turkey. Turkey's actually manufacturing as well. Quite strong in Nigeria, in Kenya, in Northern Africa, the old French colonies, in Morocco, Algeria, we're quite strong as well, dealing with them out of the French office. And of course Europe, you know, it's traditionally our number one market in the UK. Everything here you see, all the systems are linked to the UK, which is linked to Dubai, which is linked to Hong Kong, which is, everything is linked to using a supplier called Level 3 Global Crossing. It's a company that links your division, your various divisions together, which is again very important. As I mentioned, we have divisions around the world. As I said, each division have their own general manager. That's how we operate it, you know. And each general manager reports into my brother, the group CEO, and they have full responsibility for their own P&L, for their own perfumers, for their own resource, consistent with the budgets that are agreed every year and the strategy of the group. Then separate to those divisions, we have four or five group functions. Some of them are done in the UK, some of them are done in Hong Kong, and they are things like purchasing, global purchasing. We have to do that centrally so everyone can benefit from getting great raw material prices. And the other one is R&D. You know, we've got a very strong R&D department in the UK.
That's going to get people visiting. Because, you know, when you look at the figures actually now, we have, over the last 30 years or so, we have contracted in terms of the UK as a trading nation. It's now, it's one-fifth of British companies which export, and it's a quarter is the average in Europe. And too many companies have gotten kind of comfortable with the domestic market.
Absolutely.
And you know, now, I mean, you're doing well in the UK, but I know that aren't, because domestic demand is constrained. And they've got to export. So that's the big drive that's on your
mind. Because the people that can afford a current price for shampoo, is, you know, there's a huge amount of them can't afford them. They're still getting paid regularly.
But it's also, the other thing that's really inspiring is to see a company of your size and your business model doing this, because again, you know, our figures show us that what we describe as mid-sized companies, which is about 25 million to 500 million turnover, their performance collectively compared to a similar cohort in Germany or France internationally is very weak. And companies that size are just too focused on the domestic market, and they're not exporting, so we've got a particular big drive on that cohort of companies as well, because, you know, these are mature companies, so they should be able to export more. It's exactly what we need. It's the sort of balance that you have, 85% export, 15%